Wildfires are a big problem, for sure. WPI is sort of uniquely situated in our region to help us to address these problems. That's one of the things that this wind tunnel is really helping us to do. Fire is a very complex system. There's a lot of variables that are associated with fire. Why does a fire spread quickly one day and slow the next day? There's many, many variables that go into that. Wind, the topography, the fuels, the distribution of the fuels, how the weather. All of those things really, really, you know, guide what a fire is going to do at any individual place and time. And so what we like to do is sort of pull as many of those variables out of the equation as we can so that we can actually understand one or two of them. And so this wind tunnel allows us to really control the wind and the fuels, and so we can really focus in on those things, and then we can start to build on that sort of basic understanding to come back around and get at the larger problem. It becomes a real safety issue, firefighter safety issue, and also just public safety issue, that when a firebrand is lofting, it changes the position of the fire very rapidly. And so understanding how that happens is very important. And we really don't know all that much about how firebrands are created or how they travel. And so that's one of the things we're looking at here as well.
Fans on 15.
We can manipulate that to some extent in this lab in a way that we can't do really in the field.
You guys ready?
Yeah.
Ready.
Perfect.
Sorry.
So the whole demonstration sort of came by why candles aren't allowed at WPI.
Fire desk involvement from the chat.
Here we go, we have a flashover. Alright, if it gets warm, just back up.
Yeah, you guys can back up.
I had this tree freshly harvested from a tree farm about 3 weeks ago, and it hasn't been watered since. This can really create a significant fire hazard because it starts to deplete the water content of the tree, and as trees dry out, they become more and more flammable.
There are some countries whose predominant resource for oil is the Arctic. The concern is, what happens if there's an oil leak? Where will that oil flow? You'll really be affecting the entire ecosystem of the entire planet if there's a massive oil spill in the Arctic. Because you can't deploy heavy machinery, you can't deploy ships in Arctic conditions, it's not really possible to clean up the oil by mechanical means. So even though burning oil in place is the easiest way of cleaning up the oil spill, it's still difficult to ignite, and the burning rates are still low. So we are researching how to optimize this process. So what we have created is a technology called Flame Refluxer, which captures the heat from the fire and transmits it back into the fuel, thereby increasing the combustion efficiency. to 10 times. The longer you let oil or any kind of hazardous waste linger, the more damage it does. And that's what this technology does. The flame refluxer allows you to significantly reduce the cleanup time. So we have also found this technology works well in other applications, like disposing of hazardous waste. The flame refluxer technology will change industry by providing a simpler solution. You're significantly decreasing the time it takes to clean up an oil spill. It's highly economical compared to what exists right now. The technology is so simple, it has no moving parts, and it has a significant enhancement in the burning rate, and it is really cheap. So I think if in the next oil spill, we can easily deploy this technology.
Right now, so much of the heat is lost to the atmosphere that it's not efficient. This device will capture that lost heat and will redirect that heat back into the oil to produce more vapors, making even more crude oil available to burn and remove it from the environment. I'm seeing a nice gray, like a dove gray type of smoke, and even some white mixed in there. And I'm also hearing cracking. So this is a cleaner technology. It's burning hotter instead of a typical 600, 700 degrees. Yesterday we had it up to 1700 degrees Fahrenheit. Clean burns come from hot fires.
The in-situ burning is already a very successful burning process. It removes a lot of the oil from the environment, from the marine environment, but we want to actually improve the air quality for our first responders, as well as just any environmental impacts to the air environment as well.
The second biggest advantage of the blanket and flame refluxer is after we burn it, you can collect the residue with the blanket. So again, it reduces the amount of the cleaning time.
In the future, when we need this technology, it's going to be available, it's going to be tested, it's going to be proven, and we'll be able to really protect the environment.
700-800 centigrade gas temperatures at the ceiling.
The sheetrock's coming off in that back part, so, of the ceiling. A lot of surface burning of the OSB on the ceiling.
To 850, now it's 730.
That's because we have burning into the other rooms.
We had a lot of thermocouple sensors in the cracks of the compartment from the earthquake damage, so that we could see where, from the earthquake, there was more significant damage than would be in a normal compartment.
You really tell, I mean, the things, like over here, it's almost pristine, but in that quadrant, it's really sooty. So you had to breach around the edge there.
All of our building codes that we have to enforce as a jurisdiction rely on testing like this in order to advance our science and our understanding of how buildings perform in both earthquakes and in fire events.
At the end of the day, ultimately, what we're doing with these tests is we're trying to make it safer for occupants of the building and for people responding to this fire so that they can safely get in, do their job, and get out.
To see fire coming out of a big window up on a six-story building and in a structure that's not a traditional structure. This is an all-metal framed building with just drywall over the framing. So to see how this building holds up under fire conditions and what was presented to could be presented to firefighters showing up was invaluable.